Good evening. Tonight at the snooker decides which four men over the next 2 days will play for this year's Rothmans Grand Prix. Quarterfinal day, we had two matches this afternoon. This is what happened. John Parrott, the world's number three, is gone. He started well. His game went to pieces a little after that. Steve James's long potting came through, and James is through by the score of 5-3. And on the other table, Neil Foulds is gone. Nigel Bond, the giant killer, who's knocked out Davis, Charlton, Thorne, has now knocked out Foulds as well. The score there, 5-2. This is how it all sorts itself out. Bond will now play either Jimmy White or Eugene Hughes, one of our two matches tonight, and Steve James will play either Stephen Hendry, the world's number one, or Peter Francisco. And that's the match we'll start with here this evening. It had a rather odd start. Peter Francisco broke off, and Hendry, with his first shot of the match, fouled the pink. So as we join it, Francisco is leading 6-0. Your commentators, Eddie Charlton and Clive Everton.
One, 6. Seven. Fifteen.
Three reds still in the open. After this red, is Stephen in a strong position so early in the match?
Forty-seven. Fifty-four. 55.
More of a cut on the blue than he intended, but not all that difficult for Stephen, and he'll certainly get the cue ball into the pack of reds.
Stephen Hendry, 55.
He missed the blue doing it. A useful start, but it looked like being even better.
One. Six.
Calculated risk, thought that he'd bounce the cue ball off the bunch and finish on the black. But that hasn't finished very well for him. There was a lot of pressure on that pot. Francisco had little alternative but to go for it. And he knew that if he missed, he was virtually giving the frame away.
One.
Tighter for the blue than it first appeared. Now Hendry's got himself into a little bit of bother by playing his first shot a little carelessly.
Three.
Using the rest isn't the strongest part of Hendry's game, but that was okay.
Four. Eleven. Twelve.
Hendry's done more than enough to 26. Win this opening frame. It seemed to me that he was more keyed up for the start of this match than he was for his previous two matches. 32. Both of which he got himself into trouble.
32. 34. 34, and the frame, Stephen Hendry.
Stephen Hendry leads Peter Francisco by the frame to nil.
With an early break of 45, Henry took the second. With a late break of 38, he took the third as well. But in the fourth, he's already played three bad shots. He's given away 12 in fouls, and he's behind.
That was a bad mistake.
One. Seven.
So with the reds and pinks, Francisco's got a chance to take the fourth frame.
Eight. Fourteen. 15. Twenty-eight. 33. Peter Francisco. One. Six. Seven. Twelve. 13. 19.
There's an angle on the pink now to drop the cue ball right behind the one remaining red.
You
can play the draw back gently for the blue or go right back to the ball colours.
27.
And from this angle he can drop behind the yellow, so he's really getting back into this match now. Should have said frame, not match. He's certainly in control of the match. In fact, he's getting into 32. Control for the frame as well.
34.
What a clearance this would be. Hendry came to the table, 52 points behind. Several reds awkwardly placed.
41. 46.
Francisco must be wondering what he's got to do to win a frame.
52.
Superb. Superb. With a 59 clearance, Stephen Hendry wins the fourth frame on the black and leads by 4-0.
Different Stephen Hendry tonight, twice on the brink of defeat in his two previous matches. What a great start. Here's what happens in frame 5. It's Peter Francisco who's behind. That's how the balls are placed, and it's decision time for the man who's 4-0 down.
One.
Was quite a good pot from Peter.
8. Nine.
There's not a ball safe, so if he can just keep the cue ball under control now, he's in with a really good chance here.
Oh, Peter Francis.
Dear.
Nine.
No, well, he certainly can't afford to miss those. He's been playing so well in his earlier matches, but he's been kept away from the table in this match, and it does make a difference.
One. Seven. Eight. 13.
Could be that Francisco has played his last shot for the day.
14. 20. 21. 27. 28. 34. 35.
When Hendry pops the black, Francisco will need several snookers. 'No doubt about it, this has been Hendry's best performance of the tournament.
42. 43. 43.
Hendry struggled to beat Silvino Francisco, uncle of Peter, and had a lot of trouble with Elaine Robidoux as well.
48. 50.
But tonight he's looked altogether different. Sharper, keener, more competitive.
53.
And hitting the ball very, very well.
57. 62.
Seems to me that Hendry is coming to his best at just the right stage in the tournament.
62. Frame in the match.
And with that break of 62, Stephen Hendry completes a 5-0 whitewash.
Stephen, that one looks slightly easier than the last two matches.
Yes, a lot more hassle-free than the first two matches, definitely.
What did you feel about your play tonight?
I felt, obviously, I'm very fortunate to still be in the tournament tonight. I should have been out twice this week already. So I think it made me relax more and sort of enjoy the fact that I was still in the tournament and enjoy my match a lot more.
Let's look back to the two previous matches against Silvino Francisco and Elaine Robidoux. You had nightmares in that, didn't you?
Absolutely. The first match, Silvino missed a relatively easy red to put me out.
You were one ball from going out there.
Oh, literally. I mean, he had two or three chances, I think. And I'd faced the fact that I was going home early. And then Elaine missed a simple pink to go 4-3 up on me. And I managed to do a good clearance then. So I was out then as well, really.
But Peter Francisco, I mean, he had a bad patch, but he's suddenly become a very good technical player. What were you feeling when you went into facing?
Basically, as I said before, I was determined to just relax and enjoy my snooker tonight. And I think I did that a lot more than I've been putting myself under a little bit of pressure, perhaps trying too hard in the first two matches. So I was determined to relax.
You said, I think, before that being world champion and being world's number one seems to make every match more difficult.
Yes, it's something that I never thought would happen, but it does unconsciously put a little bit more on you, because obviously that your opponent's going to be trying the hardest to knock you off.
Are you conscious every time you play a match that you're number one?
No, not really. Before, I'm always trying to prove, you know, that I'm justified in being number one, and that's possibly why I tried a little bit too hard this week, trying to play better than I really should do all the time.
Steve James, then.
Yes, it's going to be quite an attacking game, I should think. Attacked by flies here. So I'm looking forward to it. It should be quite an open game, and plus it's 17 frames as well, which will give us a chance to settle in a lot better.
That makes a big difference, doesn't it? Because these best of nines in the early stages, you make one mistake and you're in trouble.
That's right. Well, if you lose the first two frames in a best of nine, you're under pressure completely. But 2-0 down in a best of 17 is not quite the same problem.
John Parrott was full of praise for Steve James after his match today. He actually said, don't know if you've heard it yet, that he felt that Steve James's long potting was better than yours.
On this week's performances, I would say that definitely. But obviously, everyone believes that they're a better player than the next player. You've got to have that self-confidence, so there's no point in turning up. But I'm just looking forward to the game. You do get chances against Steve. It's just a matter of taking them.
Well, good luck. You can go off. If that Chinese restaurant's not shut yet, you might get a meal.
Thanks very much.
Hope you've eaten. They'll all be shut by the time this programme's over. So, anyway, there's the result then. Stephen Hendry beating Peter Francisco 5-0. And now plays Steve James, who, as you know, has beaten John Parrott 5-3 in one of tomorrow's semi-finals. Nigel Bond is through as well, which leaves us with the match we're going to see now. Eugene Hughes versus Jimmy White.